Hey yo, welcome back to CG Hacks. I'm Dustin Valkema, and today we're wrapping up our two-part series on how to create a grunge scratched metal material in Cinema 4D and Redshift. Today we're using our scratch textures. Go ahead and check them out, link in the description if you're interested. I'll catch you in Cinema 4D. All right, we've got our render view running here in Cinema and Redshift. We're going to start off by bringing a few nodes in, just like we did in the previous video, to get us rolling here. Now, we've already got our paint material set up. Let's go ahead and rename this a moment. This will just help us keep a bit organized, although we should understand where, where all of that's coming from as we get going. Now, we'll pull in a material blender. This is what we'll use to create our scratched material. We'll also bring in a new standard material. And this is going to be our metal. We'll use a color layer node so that we can start to stack different materials or textures rather on top of one another to create a nice alpha channel. And we'll also bring in a triplanar node. This will help us project our textures on all axes so we don't have to worry about UVs. And we can bring in a value node so that we can scale our texture. You can close out of there for a moment. Let's start with our material blender here. Bring this off to the right towards our output a little ways. We'll take our painted material and we can bring this into our material blender as the base color and then our standard material as our layer one material color. Rename our standard material to metal so that we know exactly what that is as we get going. We'll connect our material blender to the surface of our output node so we can see it. And now for our color layer node, since we're only going to be starting off with one texture, we'll want to head into the general tab and we can disable layer one for now. That just ensures that we don't end up with a black texture when we don't intend to. All right, because we have our metal material, we want to create a new alpha channel or a layer mask that we can use to blend these two different metal and painted materials together. And this is going to be done by taking our color layer node, plugging this into our material blender, and then to the layer one blend color. So now wherever we're seeing white in this color layer node, it's going to show the metallic scratches on our material. So in order to set the rest of this up, we're going to need a texture. We're going to want to find a texture that has a nice bit of variation or breakup. We can definitely stack these on top of one another. And I think for now, we can run with something maybe like this. We'll just take 0,8 to start off with, and we can blend other different textures together using this color layer node. So we'll bring this texture into our node editor here a moment. We'll plug our scratch texture into our triplanar node as before on image X. We'll take our float node, set our input to 1, and then plug our float node into our triplanar node under the coordinate scale. Now this is the first texture that we're going to be using in our color layer, so we can plug this directly into the color or the base layer color of our color layer node. And now we can solo our color layer so that we can see exactly what's happening with this texture. And it's looking quite a bit small. So what we'll need to do here is take the float value and place this at something like maybe 0.1. And with these textures, I like to push these a bit, especially when I'm using them for something like a blend color or a layer mask, an alpha channel, and so on. So what we'll do is we'll take our color space from auto, file.io, and we'll go to raw. This will open it up and give us a little bit more dynamic range, as we can see here in the viewport. As always, I like to push values a little bit more here. And what we'll do in this case is grab a ramp node, and we'll plug this ramp node right in between our triplanar and the base color one of our color layer node. Let's see if we can scale this over so we can see our attribute manager here a little bit better. Taking our white point, we can crunch this off to the left. That's going to give us a bit more detail here. Turn the solo off on our color layer so we can see the effect of the way that these two materials are blending. All right, now it's going to be a little bit difficult to see here because in our standard material that we have for the metal, we haven't quite set up the metal material yet. So to do this, we'll set our base color to black, and now we can head down to our IOR and set our IOR at something like 4.5. This isn't really meant to be very technical. This is just giving us a bit of information that we can use here for the material. And we can already see bits of our scratch texture showing through. Now, with scratches, you're generally going to have bump. Now, the bump I'm actually going to place into our paint metal material or our paint material so that that's going to be bumping around our scratch texture. Sounds a little bit complex, maybe. We'll go ahead and grab a bump node. There we are, bump map. We can pull that into our node editor. Take our color layer now, plug this into our bump map node as the input. And we can take our bump map node now and plug this into the bump input of our paint material. Now, when I'm setting these up, it's going to be very crazy at first. So we can already see a bit how crazy this is getting inside of our render view. And so I'm actually going to take a look at not the beauty pass, but the bump normals pass. And this is going to give us a really good idea of exactly what's happening. Now we can see here that it looks like our bump is going in the wrong direction. And that's because our color layer node, if we move our bump map out of the way here just a little bit, it's because our color layer node is creating a white where the scratches are and black for where they're not, because this is creating an alpha for the material blender, but we want to reverse that. So I'm going to use a ramp node. We can plug our ramp right in between the color layer and our bump map node here. Now in the attribute manager with the ramp selected, we can right click down in the gradient and then invert gradient. And that's going to flip the normal direction or the bump direction for the scratches. There we go. Give that a moment to resolve. Maybe pull our render region down just a bit here so we can see this a little bit better. And we'll actually keep it down on the bottom here. All right. We currently have a lot of crunchy details, and that's because we have the full amount of bump. And this isn't really a great way to work from my experience. I like to start to tone this down a ways, and we can accentuate it in post, but I like to use the bump normal render pass here so that I can see exactly how far this is getting pushed. Now, in order to work with the bump values that we have, I like to use the ramp rather than the bump map node to control the height. So we'll select our white point and we can twirl down our color here. And I'm going to decrease the white values that we have. And we'll see here in the render view that this starts to bring those scratches a little bit closer to the surface so that they're not really going too deep. And I think this is a value that might work good for us now. So we have a nice bit of scratch around the surface of our model. And we can see this here. These scratches are looking pretty good. We may want some edge wear and tear that's also going on with this. So similar to how we created the grunge on our paint material, we can also create grunge and add that to the alpha channel of our metal material. So we'll use the color layer for this still. We can grab a curvature node. And we'll drop this right in to our layer one mask. Let's solo our color layer node here, and we won't see anything right away. And this is because we have to change the blend mode that we're using and also enable the layer one. So for layer one, we're going to take the color and we'll make this white. There we go. We can see this taking effect. And instead of the blend mode normal, what we're going to do is use add. And this will allow us to see the rest of the scratches around our curvature node and just add all of these different values together to create a single map. And now we can start to adjust our curvature node to really tighten this down. So we do want convex instead of having concave like we had prior. And this is going to give us a nice benefit here of being able to really solidify the way that this map is going to work. So what we'll do here first is we can grab our radius and start to tone this down. We'll say something like 0.1, and we'll see that now we're getting a good radius around the edges of our model. We can go even further, 0.05, tighten that in a ways. And now we can grab another scratch texture and use this scratch texture as a radius if we wanted to do that as well. We can browse through our scratch textures, find something that is very heavy, maybe something like this. This is a bit wild. And pull that directly into our node editor. I'm going to copy the triplanar and the float node that we already have placed. We can just duplicate those down. Plug our new scratch texture into our triplanar, image X, select our scratch texture, and we can change our color space again down to file IO and raw. And now we can plug this into our curvature map under general and radius. There we go. And now we're getting a very crazy radius here. We can scale this down a lot. So we'll go maybe a value of 1 for the input, increase the tiling rate here quite a bit. And now in order to push this further, what we can do is grab a ramp node and really crunch those values down. So we'll take the ramp node and we'll plug that in between the triplanar and the curvature. And let's crush these blacks down quite a bit here. There we go. And now we can see this really starting to take effect on the edges. And as we start to expand the range between the black and white values, we'll start to see those edges really come back. I think we can take our float value here and actually bring this up to maybe something like 2, bring that a bit smaller in scale. So it looks like we have nicks just around the edges here. I like that bigger. Okay, so we'll head to maybe 0.75. And now we'll duplicate our curvature node, not the float here. Duplicate the curvature node, and we can actually use this as our layer 2 color. So we'll head into our color layer node. And now we can enable layer 2 with our mask all the way up currently. We can set our blend mode to add. And this is going to give us a nice solid core to these worn edges. And so what we'll do is select our second curvature node. And we can set our values for this down to something like 0.01. So we just have a very thin edge or a core to the inside of the scratches that we already have laid over it. All right, let's disable our color layer node, or disable the solo here so we can see exactly what's happening. And now we can see that we have some nice worn edges right along the sides of our model. And we can always increase this visibility now by adjusting these two curvature nodes. The bottom one here, which is the core, we can adjust if we go to maybe something like 0.1. We'll see that we have quite a bit of grunge and scratch edges here. It's a little bit too far for my general liking. Maybe set that to something like 0.05 again. And let's take a look at what this looks like. All right, and we can see that we have a pretty good look here. Now, we may want to actually bring up the bump values here a little bit further so that we can see those better. So this will be quite easy to do. Remember, we have our ramp node here that we can use to adjust this. We'll select our ramp node. We can grab our white value here now and bring this value up to maybe something like 20%. So this may look a little bit more harsh on the side panels or areas that aren't lit too well, but we can always adjust this in post a bit if we need to. Now for the metal material, we may want to make this a little bit darker of a metal so we can see these scratches a little bit better, make them more prominent in the areas with these harsh highlights. In our standard material, we'll start by taking our metalness up. This is going to help us get a little bit more variation here. We can already see that's working quite well. And now one other thing that I may do is actually take our reflection weight and start to drop this just a little bit so that we can really push some of that variation. Make it a little bit more of a dirty metal rather than the nice pristine white. So we'll start with something like 0.5. We'll go a bit drastic with it. And because we have the black as our base color, this is really going to tone down those reflections and give us much more of a darker appearance. Let's take a look overall here. All right, I think we may want to bring our weight up to something like 0.75 for a reflection on the metallic material. But overall, I'm really liking the way that this looks. Now, as I'm doing this, oftentimes I'm going to be checking out the specular lighting pass as that starts to come into play. This is really going to help me know exactly what contribution I'm going to have here once I get to post and how far I can start to push these materials. Once we get to specular lighting, we can see that we have quite a bit of reflection happening in our paint material. And I may want that a little bit more, we'll say matte, if you will. So selecting our paint material, we'll head to weight here. And we're going to take our weight down quite a ways to something like maybe 0.25. And now we can really see the contribution that we have from our scratches and these worn edges and the way that they're really coming into play now. And this gives us a good bit of detail to visualize as we start to move forward with the project. We'll head back into our beauty. And there we go. Make the node editor full screen here if you'd like to screenshot the way that this was put together. Maybe recreate this yourself. You'll be able to see everything just fine. All right, so that wraps up part two on how to create a grunge scratch painted metal material in Cinema 4D and Redshift. As always, if you're interested in these textures, check them out. Links in the description. Now, this workflow does carry from one 3D software to another, so you don't really need to worry so much about the technicalities of what we were doing. Just know that those workflows do carry over and the processes are very similar from one package to another. Now, as always, make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Create more, say less, and stay creative. I'll see you in the next one.